It is again Hoshi Meguri, which is a Sky Speed song back from Splash Plus. Generally, this tune is on much on the easier side. But there are a few things to be careful about, especially when it comes with accidentally splashing notes over from the slides. And we're going to expect most players likely getting single-digit grades or better. But this is going to be one of the tightest competitions. Fortunately, because of the King of the Hill style format we're trying here, this is all entirely based on non-perfect judgment accuracy. So the percentages you do see on the screen, for example, we have in already on the left side, Jinta, did it not get a perfect critical break, then something like that is totally fine. It's not held against you. It's all based on how many grades you might get. We already are in a good start. Already looking really strong here, but immediately we already see like just how competitive something this the nature of this song here, considering that everything is pretty much by the books. Jinta right now is kind of on the lagging end at the fourth place end, but this might be really high seed. But you meanwhile, this is a match just simply between, I think, Bin-chan and maybe Asuka. This is already incredibly close. Wow, oh no, Kurinji is already really first. Now, the really cool thing about you have to worry about Kurinji is that this is his bread and butter. This guy can AP low-level stuff right from the get-go. You just ask him to try an AP on command, and he's most likely going to do it. And you can already see for Hoshi Meguri. That's just the nature of this chart. But everything seems pretty chill overall in that. So this is incredibly insane. Now, this is already... I'm very scared to just see about this nature, about how you already have. Between Kurinji and Bin-chan, seeing if they might be the ones that will get our first survivor ticket. And we got a full combo from Bin-chan and Kurinji. Let's see the results.
Bin-chan got 3105.
So this is now a match where Jinta and Asuka are fighting for their lives. So we're gonna see how we'll end up with this format. Festival Light is a very interesting chart because during the chorus, you might be able to like accidentally miss a few of these slide patterns. And if you aren't careful, that's going to cost you a lot. You can easily get goods on this kind of song too. So we're gonna see how the rest of this gang will do. But primarily it's gonna be Jinta and Asuka that are fighting for the remaining lives here in the tournament. That means that we have Cringy. Woo! Go Cringy! From Junta and Asuka, but it just ends up that Cringy and Vincent really had the edge. My goodness, that's already an amazing start. So let's go see about what's going to happen again real quick. And let's just get this ball rolling for the next set. It looks like our next song is the Hololive Hosho Marin cover. So everyone just give a big shout out and a big ahoy. So this is really interesting to see about how Ihon Romance is going to be. Cool. Please don't mind all of these little bits of scuffed magic because we're just kind of working on some of these kinks. Definitely as the tournament progresses, all of these is going to come like a smooth running system. Anyway, we're starting off really strong. We have Xantho and Omega 4. So I'm going to go ahead and give a quick rundown about these players over here. So Xantho is a player from Lock 1. He's known for actually having a triple S plus on Black Swan and only just started playing in 2021. And Omega 4, he's a next player. He actually has Shin 3 Don in UD Plus, so you can definitely watch out and see how he's gonna be. Right now, both players are just going really smooth. Xantho's actually getting pretty strong in the beginning right over here, but it's still bodes well for the remainder of this chart. Now, the issue with the Hoshomaru chart, I mean, there's not too much of an issue as a regular chart, but there are weird syncopated rhythms that, as a sight read player, you really aren't trying to master yourself with these kinds of rhythms. Now, Xanthos hitting a little fast. We're going to try and see if that's going to cost a bit, because remember, this is all about non-perfect accuracy. We get through the EX spin break and the love hearts as we just kind of progress into this latter half of the chart. But so far, so good with Vinchan and Grindy, though. Both Vinchan and Grindy are going really strong out of the gates out of this. It's going really well for all of them. It's literally their match to lose. Omega 4 is still holding on, though, where it's, they're both on a third and fourth match over here. Oh, but these spins, pretty solid, and do the cleanup. Okay, final scream, final burst. There we go. A full combo only from Omega 4's end, but it's a fourth place. However, it's not by percentage, it's by the judgments. You could have someone theoretically getting some pink break, and that doesn't matter. But these are incredibly strong scores across the board. You have Vinchan and Cringy with triple S pluses. That's going to be really hard to beat. Insane work. Now we're going to just calculate the scores and see who will have the upper hand here. It's incredibly strong for Vinchan and Grindy. But now the other song is Screaming Hard. Now, Screaming Hard, the Deco song. This is really interesting as a choice because it's one of those old Mai Mai charts that you have to be really careful about and really maintain your skills. It's a fast BPM chart too, which is super subject to accidentally good sliding a lot of components. It's a lot of things to be careful about, that's for sure. But you know what? It's okay. With Screaming Hard, I mean, it's a lot better than playing Niso Kohoku or whatever. I mean, if you got that right, guys. But it's an amazing, this is going to be definitely a kind of chart for Vinchan and Grindy to lose, because there are very little issues otherwise. So far, all these players are going really strong. Oh, but we have a couple drop early breaks. Be careful about where you splash over here. So far, so good for our gang. We have a pretty solid foundation coming on. Pretty solid. This is still... Cringy is just showing how impervious he basically is. His skill is impeccable, and there's just... It's really hard to just see him compete, where if he's just not dropping any grades, he's not letting any air and room go up for the other players. I don't even know how, whether Omega can even really properly catch up. Vinchan is also having a real, actual competition now with Gizanto, though, so this is going to really prove itself interesting about who will get this other survival ticket. Oh, wait, but Xantho is now taking... Oh, it's so close, actually. Right now, everyone is at basically a 100.9. Oh, but there's a slide that is incomplete on Xantho's end. You have to watch out there. This is what I exactly mean about how this chart might go. It's very susceptible to slide mistakes. Now, fortunately, in this non-accuracy thing, the slide is one. It's not worth three, it's just one. But this will be a really interesting kind of ending to see when we tabulate the results. Full combo, Ingo. We've got three SS pluses. Impressive for simply a sight read, by the way. was just a sight read. It's okay. Oh my god. Wow. Insane work.
Let's stay tuned and just get back over.